If the phrase Metro legend fits one man, it's probably Mike Petke. Your return tonight. How emotional will this be for you?
I'm going to be very honest with you. You know, it's not going to be what people might expect it to be. It's been 5 years. You know, when everything first went down, it was an emotional time. My life has gone on. I've moved on. I'm very happy with my life. It's good to be back here to see guys like yourself, a lot of workers that are still here that I miss, and the supporters, you know, and it's a chance for my family and friends in the area. We have over 100 people coming, so we'll have RSL should have a decent little support crowd up there. But it's good to get back here where basically I started.
It sounds strange to say, but this is where you want a supporter shield, but it's also where you cut your teeth as a head coach. In that time, what did you learn about what it takes to do the job?
Well, obviously the first thing I learned is not to become too loyal to something. To be quite honest, it's your blind loyalty. But it was an interesting 2 years. When I got thrust into that role, I had good people around me. I had Andy Roxburgh, I had Robin Fraser, guys who were experienced, and they helped me along. I'm obviously a more experienced and a better coach now. I'm not even close to where I want to be. But that was an interesting time. And again, no matter what has happened here, I'll always be grateful to this organization for giving me that opportunity.
The math is interesting tonight as you return. With tonight's game, at the end of the night, you'll have coached more games for Real Salt Lake than you did with the Red Bulls. You feel like you've crossed over professionally?
Yeah. Crossed over meaning?
Where there's one team in your life, yeah. And it's Real Salt Lake.
I wanted to make sure that that's what you meant. I would not have moved my family across country and taken a job if I wasn't completely sold on it. I was completely invested in it. So I'm RSL through and through. Again, to go back, the one thing I always give credit to is the supporters out there. So I'll always have them in my heart. But as an organization, I'm RSL.
How do you acknowledge them as a visiting coach tonight? I imagine that's hard.
Yeah, I don't know. You know, it would be awkward, and it probably would be wrong for me to walk across there right before the kickoff and go wave to them. That's probably not the protocol. But after the game, I'll certainly be going over there. I'm going to give them a wave from. Depends on if they cheer me or boo me. You know, you never know. They might not welcome me back too good, but I'm going to acknowledge them at some point tonight.
If somebody's watching a soccer game and they're looking at a team and they say, that looks like a Mike Petke team, what would they be looking at?
I think that's something that you and Shep could talk about. You guys are the analysts. For me, you know, we're looking to be organized tonight. We know what type of team we're playing, a team that has a specific style, and they're very good at it no matter how much you know about it. The battle is going to be huge tonight. You know, not inviting pressure, which is what Red Bull wants. You know, so my front four guys, I don't want them coming back to get the ball. They have to stay high. And spacing is going to be huge tonight, especially in Red Bull's counter press with the numbers they have around the ball. Not playing backwards, looking to break lines, looking to play direct at times, even make the game a bit ugly in the beginning to slow it down a little bit, because they just go and go and go with second, third, fourth wave of pressure.
It's a tough game. You just played on Wednesday night, obviously, but what's the greatest strength of your team so far?
Our resilience, to be honest with you. We've had some ups and downs, and when we have our ups, besides Montreal, but the previous three games, we're a very good and exciting team and a dangerous team. The consistency has to get better, but we do have a young team, and once that consistency gets there, you know, I think we're going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Mike, good luck tonight, and as we wrap up, he had two homes with this organization, Giants Stadium back in the day and Red Bull Arena, where he really established himself as a success on and off the field, on the sidelines as a coach.